Hello, I'm Tim Cockrell from Wise Media. I'm here with Randa Krishma from the Police and Border Guard Board from Estonia.
Yes, that's right.
Welcome. Interested to talk to you about the EID program that I understand is in place and operating at Estonia's borders, which is part of the whole program of managing border control and improving what is going on. How has that made a difference to your borders?
It's a big difference because today we talk time before the system and time after the system, and this is 100% different times. It's Estonia has a very big border with Russia. And of course, it's a lot of tourists, a lot of businessmen, and a lot of goods cross border every day. And of course, we never can build up this kind of big checkpoint that to serve this all these people. And we had this kind of border queue problems over 10 years. A lot of trucks was near the road and waiting border crossing. It was sometimes 6, 7, 8 days. And of course, Estonia, we have also winter time where it's minus 30 degrees.
So you have weather problems to deal with as well. Yeah.
And it's also like nobody problem. It's a political problem was started then when truck or car entered to the checkpoint, but before that was nobody problem.
So how does the system actually work?
System, it's work. It's very easy. We have a call center, we have a website, we have waiting areas. Truck driver or logistic can book time to cross border. Like buy airplane ticket.
Oh, okay.
And there are a lot of different ways, but it's better ways booked when you want to cross border. Let's take a truck driver who started driving to the Estonian-Russian border, exactly. From Berlin. Before that, has to drive all this to Europe to that Estonia.
Yes.
And then he's or she started wait on border queue. But now he know exactly what day, what time he want to cross border, and he booked for logistic book, and he has to go right time, right place. That's it.
Okay. So how far in advance would he need to book, for example? I mean, is it days or?
There are a lot of different rules, but it's today we can change these rules very easily.
Yeah.
But today is 90 days earlier you can book time.
Okay, up to 90 days.
It's for trucks, and of course this is for buses and for light vehicles.
Sure.
And before this system started, also family people waiting on this line, this live queue. Of course, it wasn't 7 days, but it was maybe 14 hours. Mm. Or something. Yeah.
And do you find that people in the main are on time? They actually make their appointment? Does it?
Yes,
they do.
Very well. Yeah. Because there are how many crossers border is of depend on Estonian side and of course on the Russian side. And we allowed poop only 50% on 1 hour.
Mm-hmm.
Example, when we can serve 20 cars per hour, then pooped it's made only 10 cars. And of course, these 10 cars cross border first, and after that, cars who is staying in live queue. Mm-hmm. And then something problem, maybe this hour is cross-border only 10, then this who booked absolutely goes to the kind of cross-border. Mm-hmm.
And just one last thing I was quite interested to think is with coaches and buses, you've got quite a lot of tourist trade. Obviously on the one side, some of them, you've got the whole passport control issue as well to deal with on the Russian side.
Yes.
Does that form part of this process as well?
It's coaches is a little bit different because when a truck driver put to the database names and passport numbers and so on, then coaches they put only coach driver name and data on bus.
Exactly.
Nobody put all people who is sitting in the coach.
The coach, yes.
And of course, it takes time to take normal border control, of course. But our next step that we want to integrate it, that this is border electronic border management system with our entry exit system. That data what they put to the this system going through to the our entry exit system, it's save all also some kind of time to control to put data on checkpoint also to the
So it's an ongoing developing system.
Yes,
there's more
of
things
course,
to
because,
do.
It's, we have a public partnership, how is PPP?
Public-private partnership.
Public-private partnership. Yeah. And we put to contract that they have to improve this system during 5 years. We have contract for 5 years and they have to improve that. I have to send on an email and they do it that.
Oh, I see, okay.
I don't need any kind of budget money for that.
Okay, so it's an ongoing developing ideas.
And of course, because that this company is very, they want to improve this system also, because they started this like pilot project using this same system on Russia, on Lithuania. Mm-hmm. And very soon it's made they will start this this kind of system build up in Finland.
Okay, so
and lot of countries discover that this like system is very good. Why? Because it's system changed paradigm. Before that, all people want to go to the who want to cross border. They go to the checkpoint and are waiting. Nobody knows how many people there, how big is live queue. But now they can check on live website. Okay, there is 10 hours, then 5 hours. Okay, I book time, I go with my family to the St. Petersburg on weekend, okay, I book that. I think it will be normal activities in future, because nobody goes to the airport
and waits for a
and
plane.
Wait,
exactly.
Plane and yeah. To go to the Abu Dhabi. Mm. They all buy ticket before.
Yeah.
And I think it's happened in Poland also.
That's very interesting. That's a good idea, I think. Maybe lots of other countries should do it. Some of the borders I cross are pretty bad.
Only maybe some difference.
Yeah.
We don't have money to build up the system. That's why today our who want to use the system has to pay.
Sure.
But Lithuania government gave money and it's a system for free.
Okay.
But it's basically the same system.
Yeah, it saves them time.
Yes.
Good. Well, thanks a lot for talking to me.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.